Hello students, so the next exercise which we are going to see here is the fuselage load distribution. So this exercise seems to be a difficult exercise, but we can do this exercise very easily with the help of the Excel sheet, because all the formulas and all the graphs has been incorporated in the Excel sheet. So before getting into the fuselage load distribution, I request all to submit the previous exercise, that is the VN diagram. Some of you have not submitted your the exercise number one, thinking that your teammate has submitted, so we are not needed, but that is the submission is not needed from your side. So don't think like that, because each and everyone has to submit on your own. Based on that only I can evaluate your performance. So I request all to submit the exercise number one, that is VN diagram, as early as possible. Still the submission is open, I have not closed the submission, but from today onwards, if I am giving any time period, then you have to submit on the time. Okay, so that is the only thing from my side. So let us go into the first, let us go into this session, that is fuselage load distribution. So once you have downloaded the fuselage load distribution Excel sheet from the Google Classroom, as we have mentioned in the last class itself, so how to download and how to open all these things, which you have already discussed in the last session. If you have any doubt, you can just refer the previous video. So with the video itself, we can easily download and save it in your mobile phone, and you can just edit with the Microsoft Office or the Microsoft Excel. Okay, so now let us go into this fuselage load distribution. So once you have opened it, you will be getting multiple tabs like input, fuel weight of fuselage, payload, fuselage structure. Like this, you will be getting multiple things. You'll be getting multiple tabs. Okay, so like this, you'll be having multiple tabs. So first open up the input. Okay, just click this input. Then after clicking the input, you'll be having a sheet like this. That is input data. If you see this, you'll be having an input data. So this input data you have to fill up. Okay, so whatever the datas which we can see here, that is the yellow highlighted datas, these datas are corresponding to your aircraft. You have to fill up all these datas of your aircraft, of your selected aircraft. Okay, so and then after filling up this column B, then you have to fill up the column E. Okay, so this column E has multiple datas. These datas has to be filled based on this green color shaded portion. So if you look at this green shaded portion, you'll be having multiple statistical data of the weight based on its structure. For example, if you're going to have the tail section, for the tail section you have some statistical data, and for vertical tail section you have some statistical data, fuselage structure and wing main structure, main wing structure, and then engine structure. So all these things you have some statistical data. So based on this statistical data, you have to fill up this column. You have to fill up this column E. Okay. So first let us fill up this column E. That is the first thing, the fuel weight. So this fuel weight has to be taken from the ADP 1, Aircraft Design Project 1. If you have the data, you can just fill up. Otherwise, search through Google and search for the aircraft name and search for the fuel weight of that aircraft. Okay, so it will be readily available in the Google. So just search and fill up this fuel weight. So once you have filled up the fuel weight, and then you have to fill up the payload. So this payload also you have to take it from the Google. Okay, so this payload will be available in the Google itself. So you can just fill up the payload accordingly. Okay, so the first two thing you have to search and fill. You have to search through Google and you have to fill up the first two data of the column E, that is fuel weight, the fuel load and then the payload. So these two you have to fill up from the internet source, and then the remaining four items, that is the structure, engine weight, wing structure and tail structure. So for these thing you have to refer this table. So first we will fill up the structure. So that is the structure here, it represents the fuselage structure because we are concentrating on the fuselage load distribution. So we will be having this the structure as the fuselage load or the fuselage structure. So for that we have some statistical data here. That is, for fuselage you have to take the wetted area of the fuselage. So you have to search through the Google and you have to collect the wetted area of the fuselage, and then according to your aircraft, for example if you are having a that is fighter aircraft, you have to take this value, that is 4.8, or you have the general aviation, and that is a two-seater trainer kit or four-seater trainer, or in case of if you are having any business class aircraft, so you can just take this as your general aviation as your category, and you can take this value for the calculation of fuselage weight. And similarly, if you want to calculate for the commercial aircraft like transportation and even some bombers, that is heavy aircrafts, you can go with this value, that is 5. Okay, so and then you have to calculate the fuselage weight or fuselage load like this. That is, the fuselage load is equal to the formula, you have to take it as wetted area of the fuselage into this factor. For example, if your aircraft is military based aircraft, then you have to take the factor as 4.8, and if you have the transportation aircraft, then you have to take the load factor, that is the factor is the 5. Okay, so this is for transportation and this is for the military purpose. So like this you have to take the factor and you have to multiply with the wetted area. Okay, so then you will be ultimately you will be getting the fuselage weight or fuselage load. Then you have to substitute it here. Chariya, so once you have got the fuselage structure, you have to substitute in this column, that is E. The next thing, you have to calculate the engine weight. Next we are going to calculate the engine weight. Similarly, you have as we did with the fuselage, we have to do the calculation for the wing as well. Okay, so for the wing you can see here, this is the main wing. So for the main wing we have the wing area, and then we have the factors and then the values. Okay, the multipliers. Okay, so like this you have to calculate, that is for main wing, the main wing you have the same formula, that is the factor, you have to take the wing area, and then you have to multiply with the multiplier value. For example, if you are going to take the military purpose aircraft, then you have to take 9 as the multiplier. So ultimately you will be getting some value. So this value you have to substitute in this wings engine weight, and then you have to calculate for the wings so the thing which we have discussed is for the main wing. So you have to substitute it for the wing structure. So the next day for engine weight, you have to take the last thing, that is installed engine. Okay, so the you have to take the uninstalled engine weight into 1.3, which is common for all the category of the aircraft. So you can just take the uninstalled engine weight of your aircraft and multiply with this 1.3. And then similarly for the tail structure, you have to take two tails. One is the horizontal tail, another one is for the vertical tail. You have to individually calculate the tail section and you have to sum up. That is the total tail weight. The total tail weight will be equal to the horizontal tail plus the vertical tail. So you have to calculate the weight of the horizontal tail individually and vertical tail individually. Then finally you have to sum up these two weight to substitute in this column E. Okay, so for the tail structure. So that's it. If you have substituted all these datas, then ultimately you will be getting all the graphs of the fuel weight of the fuselage, payload and fuel structure, engine weight, wing structure, tail structure. So you'll be getting all the graph accordingly. And ultimately the one thing you have to do here, for example your engine weight, so if you look at this these datas, that is 0.6, 0.6, 0.6. Okay, so if you look at these datas have corresponding to the wing position. This is the a wing position. Okay, so if your engine is positioned at the wing, for example, if your engine is positioned at the wing, then you can directly take this as the value. But in some cases, in some aircrafts, the engine weight or the engine will be positioned in the fuselage, most probably in the that is the nose section of the fuselage. In such case, that is if your wing, if your engine is placed in the fuselage at the nose section, then you have to take the X by L start and X by L as end as 0.1 to 0.2. You can just change this value accordingly. You have to take it from 0. You can also take it from 0 to 0.1. Okay, you can also take 0 to 0.1. That is, you have to substitute the value of X by L start as 0 and X by L end as 0.1. So, like this, you have to change this value, the start and end value. Don't change the resultant, it will automatically change accordingly. Okay, so it will change automatically. Okay, so no need to change the resultant value. Okay, so I have already incorporated the formula for the resultant value. That is, it's an average, it's just an average. In case if you have modified the resultant data, you have to take the average of those data and then you have to substitute it here. Or you can just substitute just the X by L start and X by L end of the wing. Okay, so and then one more thing, if you have two engines, if you have two engines which is positioned at the wing, that is one at the starboard and one at the port, then you have to multiply with the two engine weight. You have to take the two engine weight and then you have to substitute it here. That is, you have to multiply by two and you have to substitute in this column. That is the column E. Okay, so this is how you have to give all the input data for the fuselage load distribution. So after giving all these data, you will be automatically getting all the graphs of the multiple section. That is, you will get the graph of the fuel weight of the fuselage, and then payload of the fuselage, fuselage structure, engine weight, wing structure, as well as the tail structure. So you can see all the graphs of these things. Okay, so you'll be getting the shear force. You'll be getting the shear force diagram and the bending moment diagram of all the loads. Okay, of all the loads, you'll be getting the shear force and the bending moment diagram. Okay, so I expect all to submit this fuselage load distribution exercise as soon as possible. So I will be fixing up some deadline. So within the deadline, I expect all to submit the fuselage load distribution. So thank you all.